Greetings. Well, Faisal, I appreciate your question, and I would like to share my answer with you in a video so you can hear the clear explanation. You ask me the following. You know what, brother? It's time for me to ask you what's different between stories of the Bible and the Quran, and what I mean in my question is, why do you think Bible stories are true while Islamic stories are to you? And here is my answer, which I provided in a handful of message boxes. And I will give the scriptural basis for my statements from the Word of God. Well, Faisal, I actually believe in the God of the universe, and I know and accept His Word because He has endorsed it and proven it to be the truth. He has stamped it with what the apostles called the more sure word of prophecy. 2 Peter 1:19. We have also a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto you do well that you take heed, as unto a light that shines in a dark place, until the day dawn and the day star arise in your hearts. God foretold His Son the Messiah with more than 200 prophetic details, told by the prophets over 3,000 years. I will not reveal all 200 details about Messiah here, but show a few revealing the Son of God. God revealed His begotten Son through Prophet David. Psalm 2:7, I will declare the decree the Lord has said unto me, Thou art my Son, this day have I begotten thee. God revealed His Son through Prophet Isaiah. Isaiah 9:6, For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon His shoulder, and His name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of His government and peace, there will be no end, upon the throne of David and over His kingdom, to order it and establish it with judgment and justice from that time forward, even forever. The zeal of the Lord, Yahweh of hosts, will perform this. God revealed His begotten Son through Prophet Solomon. Proverbs 30, verse 4. Who but God goes up to heaven and comes back down? Who holds the wind in His fists? Who wraps up the oceans in His cloak? Who has created the whole wide world? What is His name and His Son's name? Tell me if you know. Now, brother, if God chose to reveal His Son by three prophets, shouldn't you respect God enough to listen to Him? No man nor group of men could ever contrive this, and we have absolute proof of record from hundreds of years before Jesus. The Hebrew Bible was translated into Greek during King Ptolemy's reign. It was completed at least 130 years before Christ was born. It is called the Septuagint, loosely meaning the translation of the 70. Therefore, we know God revealed the prophetic predictions before Jesus was born. This could not be faked after Jesus. In fact, the silliest cop-out to reject God's clear proof is to claim a fake written later. The second most intellectually bankrupt dodge is to claim the Bible was changed later. And that is worth a video all by itself, brother, the provably false claim that the Bible was changed. This more sure word of prophecy is the proof, brother, that God revealed the Torah and the Bible. And if a person respects God, they would respect the message He proved to be the truth. Simply stated, God revealed that He was the Redeemer of mankind. Isaiah 47 verse 4, As for our Redeemer, the Lord of hosts is His name, the Holy One of Israel. The word translated into English as Lord is Yahweh, the personal name of God. Psalm 19:15, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my Redeemer. Over and over, brother, God is called Redeemer by the prophets. This means God will take action to save us from sin, brother. Isaiah 63:16, doubtless thou art our father, though Abraham be ignorant of us, and Israel acknowledges us not. Thou, O Lord, art our father, our Redeemer. Thy name is from everlasting. Colossians 1:13, who hath delivered us from the power of darkness, and has translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son, in whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins. So you can see, brother, in both the Old and New Testaments, God is revealed as Redeemer. I often wonder why Muhammad never called his Allah Redeemer. There is no favorable explanation, brother, which excuses his omission. God revealed that sin was a nature in human beings. We are, in our hearts, imperfect and selfish. God said, none are without sin. Isaiah 59:2, but your iniquities have separated between you and your God, and your sins have hid his face from you, that he will not hear. Romans 3:23, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, being justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. The message of the prophets, that God offers redemption for mankind, is fulfilled in Jesus, brother. And God's plan from before the world was created was to save us when we could not save ourselves. It is God's gift. Revelation 13:8, Part B, whose names are not written in the book of life of the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world. Slain from the foundation of the world. Those words mean, brother, that God knew the Lamb of God would have to be sacrificed. From the foundation. From the very beginning, brother. You see, God knew the future of mankind even before he created Adam. He even makes the end known before the beginning. Prophet Isaiah chapter 46, verse 10, I declare the end from the beginning, and from long ago what is not yet done, saying, my plan will take place, and I will do all my will. And if a person reads the Bible, they see the whole plan laid out from promise to Abraham, Genesis 12:3, and I will bless them that bless thee, and curse them that curse thee, and in thee shall all families of the earth be blessed. To fulfillment by his Son, the Lord Jesus. Matthew 5:17, do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have not come to abolish them, but to fulfill them. Romans 3:31, do we then nullify the law by this faith? Not at all. Rather, we uphold the law. And the Bible records the completion of the plan of God, done, finished, and in place. God's promise to bless all mankind through Abraham was culminated in the death of Jesus on the cross. After this, Jesus, knowing that all things were now accomplished, that the scripture might be fulfilled, said, I thirst. So when Jesus had received the sour wine, he said, it is finished, and bowing his head, he gave up the ghost. I want you to understand, brother, this is Satan's motive to deny the crucifixion. Satan cannot stop the reality of God's salvation. But if he can deceive you it did not happen, you will not even look for God's salvation. It does not matter where you are, brother. God's salvation is available to you. You could be a 60-year-old Muslim living across the street from the Kaaba. God knows your heart and whether you want to accept His gift of salvation. And this event literally defeated Satan and took the keys to hell from Satan as God redeemed the righteous dead from the grave. God's plan all along, brother. Colossians 2:13. And you who were dead in your trespasses and the uncircumcision of your flesh, God made alive together with Him, having forgiven us all our trespasses, by canceling the record of debt that stood against us with its legal demands. This He set aside, nailing it to the cross. And when He had disarmed the rulers and the authorities, He made a public spectacle of them, triumphing over them in the cross. Revelation 1:18, I am the living one. I died, but look, I am alive forever and ever, and I hold the keys of death and the grave. Ephesians 4:8, wherefore He said, when He ascended up on high, He led captivity captive and gave gifts unto men. But Satan was not killed or destroyed. He exists and continues to seek people to ensnare in his lies. And after 600 years, Satan, the Al-Makar, created a scheme to call God's plan a lie, a myth, a fraud, a deception. Remember how those who bent on denying the truth plotted against you to imprison you or kill you or expel you. They schemed, but Allah also schemed, and Allah is the best of schemers, the Al-Makar. Satan brought a new religion to deny God's plan of salvation, deny God's sacrifice, to deny God's very Son foretold by the prophets. And for their saying, verily we have slain the Messiah, Issa, son of Maryam, an apostle of Allah, whereas they slew him not, nor they crucified him, but it was made dubious, or made to appear unto them. And verily those who differ therein are in doubt thereof, they have no knowledge thereof, they follow but an opinion. And surely they slew him not. Surah 112.3, He begetteth not, nor is He begotten. And to this day, Satan's plan to deny the crucifixion and deny the Son of God coming to earth is believed by his false religion, brother. So you asked, brother, why I believe the Bible's stories and I consider the Quran, I do for all the reasons above and for hundreds more reasons too long for one video. The truth, brother, is that the Bible is a complete, coherent, and consistent message from Almighty God. It does not hint about any other prophet to come after Jesus, not in one single verse. And that certainty makes no room for a deceiver to come and claim he was mentioned. It does not hint about a third covenant or a third testament, a new scripture written by a man in a distant country. It does not hint about a new form of prayer, mandatory kneeling and facing a city of pagans who knew not Jehovah. I hope you honor God enough, brother, to listen and understand this video. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.